हेलो डियर स्टूडेंट, दिस ट्यूटोरियल इज गोइंग टू बी इम्पॉर्टेंट फॉर यू बिकॉज हियर आई एम गोइंग टू शो यू हाउ यू कैन कंडक्ट द स्टूडेंट ऑनलाइन एग्जाम. सो फॉर दैट यू मस्ट बी नोविंग अबाउट द गूगल फॉर्म. सो दिस ट्यूटोरियल विल बी हेल्पफुल फॉर यू इफ यू आर प्लानिंग टू क्रिएट गूगल फॉर्म, इफ यू आर प्लानिंग टू टेक स्टूडेंट ऑनलाइन एग्जाम. So let's get started without wasting the time. So here in the Google, first you have to type Google form. And just I tell you, if you are using laptop, you must be login with the Gmail ID. And if you are using smartphone, in smartphone already your Gmail ID is present because you are accessing YouTube and all. If you are not login, then you have to login with the user ID and password. So here you have to open the Google Chrome. Whether you are using laptop or mobile doesn't matter, you have to open the Google Chrome. And if you are using smartphone, you just click on the three dot. Okay, if you are using smartphone device, first you open Google Chrome, click on the three dots and you select desktop site, so that your mobile will be just like a laptop screen. So in the three dot option, you have to select which option, desktop site. And then in the Google Chrome, here you have to search Google form. Once you type the Google form, you have to select the sign in option. And here you select the plus icon. And here these things are important. And here you type the school name, whatever your school name is there, that you have to type here. And whatever the place is there, that also you have to type. And about your description, here you have to write about your subject. So here I upside, as I told you, you have to type your school name, whatever it is, and the place. And here you type your subject. So as I am just doing roughly, so whatever subject is there, that you have to type there. And then next step is, while creating the Google form, you have to type the student name first. Don't type question directly, otherwise you will be confused which student have fill up the form. So here straight away write the student name. Okay, better to give first letter capital. So here student name, by default it is short answer because student will complete in one line. So here you don't need to do anything. And here you select required option. You have to make it compulsory. Required means compulsory, means compulsorily student will write the student name. They will not ignore this, otherwise they cannot give the exam. Now here next step is click on the plus icon, and here your questions will start. Give the question number and type the question, whatever it is. Suppose I am typing, what is computer? This is my question. And here multiple choice option is there by default. I want student should give the answer like one line, two lines. So you have to select paragraph option. And here if you want required, you can select that. But if the student not knowing answer, then he is having the choice to ignore that. So I just don't want to select that. Click on the plus icon for the next question. Question number two, whatever it is, you have to type. What is IC? So second question, and here means every question I am selecting different option for your understanding. By default it is multiple choice. Here there some people they are having confusion about multiple choice and choice box. So let me clear. Multiple choice means student will select only one option, and checkbox means student can select more than one option. So I am selecting multiple choice. In multiple choice you can type the option 1, 2. Suppose third option you want to put, you can give that. And then after giving this, I just want to appear next question. Here my next question, whatever the number is there, you can give. What is memory? So if suppose any mistake happens, spelling mistake, you can correct that easily. What is memory? And here I want to select choice box, give some option. As it is a sample form, I am just writing it. And then appear for the next question, so click on plus. And my next question is fourth one. Detail about CPU. So here I want to select file upload because the question answer may be long. Continue option you select. So here these options are important. It is better if you don't select this so that student can upload any kind of file. Here I want only one file. If you want to, you can select that. Size limitation is there, 10 MB for one file. If you want it compulsory, select the required option. And here you simply click on then plus icon for the next question. So here student will give the answer in file. They will upload the image from their device. Next question is about want to put one image. My question is image related. You can type the question. And for uploading the image, you have to click on this image icon. And here these are the options. You can select camera if you are taking the photo from camera. If you are taking the image from photo from your mobile, select that. You can take from Google Drive. Image search option is the better one. Suppose you want to take any animal picture, you just search that. And suppose one pet I am selecting. And what happen in this question, student will observe the name, and whatever the names are there, they will write. So here you can write dog in the option, or whatever, cat. So student will select the correct one. And finally, this is suppose our last question. So we have completed the work, and just see this icon preview. You can verify how the student will see this. So this is the preview, means this is from the student side. So because of this preview, you can cross check your form, how it will be appear for the student. So here what student will do, they will write the name. What is computer, they will write the answer in one line. What is IC, they will select only one option, you observe. They cannot select more than one. What is memory, here we use checkbox, so student can select more than one. Here in this question, student will upload the file from their device. Click on the select file from device, they will select any file. And it will, you have to click on upload, it will take some time for uploading. And as far as possible, I suggest you, you have to avoid file option because it may be hectic for the student. So here we uploaded image, student will select the name, and they will click on, after appearing all question, they will click on the submit option. So once it is done, you can click on submit another response for the second response. Otherwise you can directly close. Here you check response option. Response means you can check the feedback of the student, whether they appear or not exam. So while checking time, you click on the response, click on this plus icon, create option you have to select, create new worksheet. So here whatever the answers are there, question names and answer is coming, okay. So this is your Excel file, and if you want, you can save in computer. You just download that, okay. If you download this in the Excel format, it will be downloaded. You see it is downloading. So in this way you can download and save also. Now I am closing this. Now I tell you how you can share, how you can share the Google form, that is somewhat important for you. So here I just go back. So this is our recent form that we have created. So in this way, in the recent form, you can open the form, and for sharing, you click on send, and here you type the email ID. And finally, you click on the send option. There is one more way. You click on the middle option in the send and shorten URL and just click on copy. Once you click on copy, if you are using smartphone, then you paste it in your WhatsApp. You just go in the WhatsApp and whichever the friend or whichever the student or whichever the group is there you just paste that link by using your fingers. So I hope how to share the Google form, and I hope you understood how to type the question, how to create, how to generate the online test, how to share, and how to check the response also. And if you go back, there is a option of the recent form. From there you can open the Google form. If you want to give the name of that recent form, if whatever you have created, you can just click the rename option and give the name whatever it is. This is the sample form, so I have written the ABC. So in this way you can give the name also. So I hope, friend, you enjoyed this tutorial, and I hope it is helpful for you. So don't forget to subscribe my channel for the notification of next video. Thanks for watching. Thank you.